a thing earlier about these sort of emerging markets, and emerging markets, they look at jewellery as they really do look at it as the component of its parts much more. You know, it's really about, it's sort of, it can be a bit fun and it can be a bit sort of out there to a certain extent, but they really start to look at the value of what you're selling them. They do analyze it, and so I've sort of gone, and my crystal haze, which is still huge for us, it's been ripped off like you cannot believe, but it's still a big deal for us, but that's not so interesting for someone in India or in China. It's not. They like to know that this is a proper gem and it's not played around with, and you know, like I said, I was tinkering. So what I do now is every year, at the end of the year, towards the end, when I do a lot of events, we sort of rewrote events so that when you come to a Stephen Webster event in jewellery, there was a little bit of it up there at the tunnels, the old Vic tunnels, which was a party we did last year, which was the one for the seven deadly sins. We take out a big theme, but the pieces are very couture. They're limited edition. Like this one is Wrath, and you can see, I mean, this is obviously blown up pretty big. This has got tiny little jewellery on it, on both the hands. The hands are beautiful, they're like really beautiful. It's strangling that garnet. And I only made seven. I sold seven. And then the one that was before with the eye, the evil eye. Can we go back to gluttony? Does that give you a bit of grief? Let's have a look at gluttony, yeah. Oh, yeah, all right, we'll have a look at that one, yes. So that one there is, that one's envy. So you can't really see the stone on top of that. Beautiful Pakistani peridot, big, like 35 carats. And then with black diamonds, white diamonds, and green garnets on the side. So everything about it is, you know, proper jewellery, beautifully made. And again, you know, just do seven. And if you want to go on to gluttony, there we go, gluttony there. It's got the best dental arrangement in the UK. They're all carved out of white agate. Each one individually carved. It's rubies. It's like mouths. So it's got four mouths, and basically you've got a mouth over each of your fingers, and you put your finger through another mouth. And in the top is a fire opal, a really amazing one. And one of my favourite things to do really to this day is go and find something that I know is extraordinary in a gem. And then I'll kind of work around it. Sometimes I save them for a long time until I find the right thing that I want to put it in. So it's really going back to this sort of, like I say, when I think back now 30 odd years in Canada, it was that really turned me on. So even though now we can be a bit more brazen, if you like, we can push it out there because we've sort of earned that, I suppose the spirit of it is really the same. It's really the fundamental parts are the same. It's about craftsmanship and it's about gems. And but, you know, now we can have a laugh as well and fun. I mean, you know, for my creative team doing these things, they love it. You know, I mean, it's not like they've got to do boring things. They've got to make chains. You know, they have to make chains. So we do have a lot of fun with the collections.